conjure up the face of the one you love. Although you have had many loves, many lovers, many faces you can summon now, there really is only one. One Pyrrhic victor. Their lips light, beckoning. One spoiled face that lies against your pillows. Their cheeks slack against the crumpled cotton of your bedlam ones, and a features that comes into your mind now when I ask you to conjure up the face of the one you love. Lay them down. Against the bed, against the floor, against the still cold of some table, and see them. Faintly childlike in their slumber. The slack gentility of features you remember sometimes better than the composite of features that is your face. Your face, which is so unfamiliar sometimes in the mirror. Not like their face, which is a twin. Some caster to your Pollux. Some double god against which we run multipliers. Duplicity, amplification. The mouth you have kissed. The eyes you have bathed in. The forehead you have smoothed in fever. The face you love and trust as much as an echo. Then let them be dead. Take the gentle rising and falling of their chest and make it still. Take the quiet twitching of their eyes, rimming to their lethal dreams, and make them still. Your eyes taking in their eyes, their nose, their mouth, their lips. The beating double drum of heart, the pump, arterial. The river throb at the throat, the aspirated reassurance of the seeming ceaseless breath, the fingernails growing, the unnameable spill of the hair. Let them be still. Let them be dead. Take them to the beach, to the ocean at night, the night at the ocean, the cliffs to the east side, the mangroves to the west, the ocean carping like a housewife never satisfied, a child never silenced through the dummy, a dog never pacified with a fat, slippery bone, the liquid tectonic hunger, the movement intractable, the obdurate glistening of the moon on the waves as it beats to the shore. Build a raft. Lash it and stack it and build it and bind it. There are a few who would help, ask them, then build it. It need only be strong enough for the task at hand. There is a man in the village who still knows how. He has a tool, some sickle-shaped tool with a hold at each end like an axe or a blade, and for a fee, he will take it to the cool skin, the still bone, the beardless body, and he will, with just a few heavy hacks, purposeless and bleak, the willful flesh resisting, the sternum holding for the fierce moments before the inevitable crack and splinter of the bone, the separation of the finger ribs from the fused knuckle, to brace open the ribs and find the heart, the lungs, the liver, the spleen, the pancreas, the stomach, and the soul, all of which you can feed to the dogs. Don't waste your love. Fill them up. Memories, mementos, tokens, feathers, shells, letters, old rings, sea glass, lucky symbols, broken jewels, fractured stones, the tie that was once worn in their hair, a scrap of fabric from a dress, a leaf from the yard, a key from the door, a handful of dirt, the sucked, clean stone of the peach you were eating at the instant you at last let them be still. Make the moan, which is heard in the ear and whispered in the seam of skin where instinct begins. Consecrate them with your quiet and the ocean's up. If your lover has a mother, let her sew the body back, closing some heartbroken circle of flesh torn and bleeding. It may take longer than you think, even with all of us, palm to chest, to throat, to thorax, to belly, to hip, to bring together the ribs and the flesh and the bone, the meaty, slippery sheet of your love reunited to itself, their skin. Half-dressed or undressed or never dressed or now newborn naked, their body filled with the load of your memory and all of the dogs on the beach hungry still. If your lover has no mother, only a father, let him sew the body back. If your lover has no father, let the children make neat stitches there. If your lover has no children, no kith, no kin, no blood, no bone, then it may yet be you. Or maybe it will be you all along. The seamstress to their final dress. No one knows until the time comes who will have the body rights. You can ask them if you remember, but it may yet be you. Maybe that's what you were earning every night when you were the last eyes open to them, earning the right to sew them in their sweetmeats, dressing them for death. Find your love. Lay them on the raft. Blanket the body in logs and wood and sticks and stones and leaves and grass and fuel for the fire, ready to burn. Then take them out. When the time comes, someone will open up a bottle of white spirit, lamp oil or kerosene, some fluid ready for the light. Not too much, just enough. There are some who still know how. Together, take them out. Some will push, wet in the water. Some will pull, heaving in the boat, creaking with the oars. Some will merely watch from the shore. There's a grey light out over the liquid, the shunt and spill of the raft. With wet, trembling fingers, light the match that will burn twice. Light your love. Liquid tectonic hunger, the movement intractable, the moon and the waves as it beats to the shore. Be strong enough for the task at hand. Some sickle-shaped blade, the ribs that can be braced apart to find the heart, the lungs, the liver, the pancreas, the spleen, the stomach, and the soul. All of which you can feed to the dogs. Don't waste your love. Some will push, some will pull.